what smelling we have. Two songs that we would like to play, and you may remain seated on the first song. And the second song, we're going to ask you to stand. We ready? Miss Mother's Day.
Mother Hallie Caesar and my sister Anne.
I want us to reflect on our mothers.
Now sleep.
They are so special. Every day ought to feel like Mother's Day. Physically, she may be gone, but in the spirit, the mother will always be with her children.
You know, I had a very good mother. The thing that I'm so glad about is that I never waited for a special day to show her how much I loved her. Mother's Day, Christmas, birthday, whatever the day was, every day was her day. Whatever she needed, if I could get it, I'd get it for my mom. I just want to say, love your mom now while you can. Show her how much you love her. Take her out sometime. Give her that.
Gave me my star.
I took a keeper in my heart.
Here is my heart.
Brother Jeremiah couldn't be here today, but we thank God for Sister Taya and Sister Leah. They're here to help with the song service. Amen. We're ready. We're going to ask that you stand for the song of the hour. Church. Give honor to the Holy Spirit, who is my comforter and my guide. I give honor to Elder Evans, Elder Williams, Elder Bradley. Special honor to our mothers today. All of our mothers, our mother board and all the mothers. The mothers that are here and the mothers that have a desire to be here but just couldn't be here. Give honor to our very powerful deacon staff. Give honor to each of you inside the sanctuary and each of you that are in the parking lot. All of my father's children. It's so good to see you this morning. I certainly give honor to my own family, especially my very lovely wife who was able to be with us this morning. I thank God for her presence. That is a word from the Lord. Amen. And if you brought your Bibles, I want you to turn with us to Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 31. We want to begin reading at verse number 10. Proverbs 31. Verse number 10, and then we'll read 25 through 31. I want to put you on notice today that as I talked with the Lord and as the Lord prepared me for this message, I want you to know that I'll be making this message very personal for some of you and for me, celebrating our mothers. Proverbs 31, verse number 10. When you find it, I'm certain you'll find these words recorded. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. 25 through 31 says, strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters, y'all listen to me, many daughters have done virtuously, but thou, the mothers, thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Amen. Give her up the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. We like to offer for a subject taken from these passages and other supporting passages of Scripture. Give honor to our mothers. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We want to give honor to our mothers. Let us pray. Eternal Father in heaven, we come at this precious hour of the morning just to say thank you. Lord, we thank you for this another day's journey and for the precious gift of life. And Lord, we thank you that you have allowed us to witness and to be a part of another Mother's Day celebration. Lord, we thank you for our mothers. We thank you for the life, Father, that they lived and for the example that they showed us. Lord, we ask that you would just use me now to preach your word, dear God. Want you to be pleased, dear Master. Oh God, we love you so much. We do lift you up, and we will forever magnify your holy name. For it's in Jesus' name we ask it all. For his sake we pray. Amen. 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 And amen. Amen. I'm excited to be here this morning. And I'm I'm so grateful to look out and see so many mothers this morning. We just thank God for your presence. We thank God for you as human beings. Mothers are a gift from God. Mothers are so precious. And like the song said, they should be celebrated every day. Every day ought to feel like Mother's Day. Mothers have a great spiritual relationship with God. And some mothers have come to realize how close they are to God. But some mothers have not reached that point yet where they don't understand how close they are to God. They have so many of the same characteristics as God. I mean, after all, God is the one that gives life. And mothers are the one that gives life. David wrote in Psalms 139, verses 13 and 14, it said, "For it was you who created my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I will praise you because I have been fearfully and wonderfully made." Every one of us was made by God inside our mother's womb. We got something to be thankful for. We didn't get here by ourselves. If I look out in this audience, in this sanctuary, nobody got here without a mother. Oh, and we ought to praise them, I tell you. We ought to love our mothers. We ought to praise them. Mothers are used by God, even now, to still bring new life into the world. And as much as we love our fathers and our men, they can't say that they ever brought a life into the world. So mothers are very special. The life of every child takes place inside the womb of a mother. Even Jesus Christ himself, his life here on earth took place inside of Mary's womb by the Holy Spirit. Every mother should be honored and respected. A saved mother goes through so much for her children. She knows how to survive for her children at any cost, no matter what it takes. A good mother knows how to survive. And I think I ought to tell you that if you as a mother raised your children by yourself, today I want to tell you that you are worthy of not just honor, but you're worthy of double honor. Good God Almighty, she is very determined. A mother endures pain at any level for her children. She has unconditional love for her children. And a lot of times she know the child don't love them back like they ought to, but mother still loves them just the same. Yeah. If your mother is still alive on this special day, you should tell your mother how much she means to you. You ought to tell her that. You ought to not let the day go by without telling your mother how much she means to you, how much you love her. And listen, some people have a little pride that they don't want to use the words that "I love your mama." They try to do other things. But today you ought to let the pride go. If your mother's alive, you ought to let her hear you say, "I love your mama." Yeah. If you can't get by and see her, please make a phone call. I've heard so many people say these words, "I wish I could just see my mama again." I've heard people say, "I wish I could hear my mama voice. I wish I could hear a prayer again." Yeah, somebody said, "I wish I could just hug and kiss my mother one more time. I wish I had a chance to show my mama how much I really love her." But today, if you have these opportunities, if your mother is still alive and you don't take advantage of these opportunities, shame on you. Because if your mother is alive, there's no excuse for you not showing love and compassion to your mother. I think I ought to tell you that one day she's going to be gone. And all you're going to have is precious memories of days gone by. Every child ought to make a sacrifice on this special day to honor their mother. We only get one. We only get one. She deserves your love. She deserves your flowers, your cards, a visit, a phone call, a nice dinner. Just do something special for your mother while the blood is still running warm in her veins and in your veins. And can I tell you that if you don't do it today, don't even worry about tomorrow. Today is Mother's Day. And you know what? If you don't have time for her today and you think about it tomorrow and you call her, you know what that means to me? That's just like a Valentine's Day that comes. And you don't get your love when nothing for Valentine's Day, but the next day you walk in with something. It don't feel the same. Ladies, do that feel the same? No. And today, if you don't reach out to your mother, if she's alive, tomorrow won't feel the same. I mean, you need to make every day Mother's Day. I know that. But today is special. It's special all around the world. I know the Lord is all right. There isn't anything that you can do or say about a mother's child that would make her stop loving her own child. Even if that child commits a crime, even if that child is in prison, you might not love the child, but that mother, I guarantee you, still loves her child. And I have a prayer. I have a prayer. My prayer is to see young mothers of today learn how to love and raise their children like our mothers did in the days gone by. That's what's missing. That's what's missing, y'all. But when you see, and the other day I saw about three boys, they couldn't have been no more than 13 to 15, walking down the street, mean mugging folks with no shirt on. And I said, Lord, what is wrong? And the problem is the home training has stopped in a lot of homes. But let me tell you this. It ain't the fathers, because the daddy's gonna be daddy. The daddies ain't never really took care of the house as far as taking care of them children. All the daddy did was the mama say, my mama would say, I'm gonna tell Lacey if y'all don't do what I tell you. But the mama was the one that raised them children and made sure that they looked well, that they dressed well. When they left the house, they were presentable. So I stop by to tell you that the mothers are slipping on raising these children. Daddy's always left home. Daddy's always had other things on their mind. But it's been the mothers. And so when I see things like that going on with the young folk, I know that the mothers are trying to run with the children. The mothers ain't got time to raise them. The mothers want to be partners and want to be friends with the little girls and the boys instead of being a mother. It's time to be a mother to your children. God Almighty. I'm just praying that the young folk will learn how to raise them the right way before it's too late. Listen, I know today is Mother's Day. And for many, it is a happy and a joyous occasion. It's the day that we celebrate our moms that are still alive, but not only that, it's the day that we celebrate sweet memories of mothers that are already gone to glory. It's a day of reflection. It's a day that you can sit down somewhere and just reflect on the life that you had with your mother if she's already gone to glory. But while many are rejoicing, getting ready to spend time with their mothers today, some are not smiling, y'all. Some are not happy. Why? Because they miss their mother so much. Everybody don't feel the same on Mother's Day. There are some mothers sad thinking about a child that they lost. And there are some children sad thinking about their deceased mother. There are some mothers still waiting on their children to say, I love you, mama. And there's still some children waiting on their mother to say, I love you, baby. Because whether you know it or not, there's some mothers who can't seem to tell their own children that I love you. Oh, Almighty. They waiting on that. And listen, I understand that it's hard for some people to say those words. And some of you, you decide that actions speak louder than words. So some of you say, well, I don't have to tell my lover, I just show up in my actions. Well, what about the time that mama gonna be on her bed of affliction, or you gonna be on your bed of affliction, and you can't put no actions to work? You need to say, I love you, mama. Mothers all over the world, I want you to know that we honor you. We give you honor today. And can I tell you that honoring your mothers, fathers and mothers, but today is Mother's Day. Can I tell you that it meant so much to God that he made it one of our commandments. It really meant something to God that we honor our parents, especially here the mothers today. And it's the first commandment, y'all, with the promise. Out of all the commandments that God gave, this was the first commandment that he gave with a promise. Yeah. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise. And here it is. So that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on this earth. What a great promise from the Lord. Yeah, if you want to enjoy, if you want your life to be well and you want to enjoy a long life, you got to honor your mother. You got to honor her. Good God Almighty. Well, why is it that it's so easy, and I see it all the time, it's so easy for folks to give honor to other folk. Walk into the courthouse, giving the judge honor. I'm like, your honor. Giving him honor. Walking into your job, you give your boss man or your boss woman honor. You'll stand there and you'll give honor to a flag. You give honor to veterans, to the president. All of that's good. But what I'm telling you is you need to give honor to your mother. Most people take their mothers for granted. God gives mothers a certain understanding about life that he don't give nobody else. They call it a mother's intuition, which is the ability to understand something immediately without the need of a conscious reasoning. God gives that to the mothers. A mother has that intuition where they understand her child. They understand things that other folks don't understand. That's why you can't fool your mother. Yeah, she knows her children. And you don't have to tell her when something is wrong, because she can look at her child and tell something is wrong with it. No matter what you say, Mama, I'm all right. She said, no, I know something wrong with you, baby. I know you. Yeah, she prays for you when you don't even know she's praying. And can I tell you that she worries about you when you don't even know she's worried about you? That's just the kind of love that mothers have for their children. Saved mothers, to me, are the closest thing to an angel. Oh, yeah. A saved mother is the closest thing to an angel. And I just thank God for our mothers. You really can't compare a mother's love to anything else except the love that God has for his children. Yeah, a good mother is in a class all by herself. And can I just say this about Ratliff? When I look at our motherboard, I just believe that all of our mothers on the motherboard here are godly mothers. And I believe that they taught their children and raised them the right way. And they're not only just the motherboard, but the mothers around Ratliff Chapel. Yeah, I told you I'm going to get a little personal today. It touches my heart when I hear mothers praying for their children. Madea, every time she talks to me, she said, Pastor, pray for my children. Yeah, and I see the love that Sister Madge and Deacon Harvey has for Madea. Madea understands that no matter how old she gets, her children and herself will always need prayer. And can I just be real with you this morning? If you have a mother still living and in her right mind, if you don't go and visit her and sit down and talk to her on a regular basis, you're missing out on the most cherished and the best memories of your life. Because I can still remember when I was young and I would sit down and talk to my mother. I could tell my mother things I wouldn't dare tell my dad. I just had that kind of relationship Brother Scoop Cherry told me the same thing. He said, me and my mama, we talk about everything. And that's a good feeling to know that you can talk to your mother, she won't judge you. Isn't it good to have an understanding mother?
Yes.
Well, I know one thing. Nothing makes my day like being able to still go and see my mother and talk to her every day. That makes my day. Just to know that she's still here with me. And I've had conversation with people that have said, you don't know how blessed you are to still have your mother with you. But I do know how blessed I am, because I don't take my mother for granted. But my heart goes out now to the ones of you that can relate to the song by Willie Banks. He said, I can't still look over in the corner and see mama sitting there. She ain't there no more. He said, she's gone home with Jesus. Now, if you can relate to that part of the song, I believe you ought to be able to relate to the rest of the song, because he continues to talk about the song. And then he says, you get down on your knees with tears in your eyes. You get down on your knees with sorrow in your heart, and you say, Lord, have mercy now. He said, Lord, you've been my mother. You've been my father too. Lord, if it hadn't been for you, I don't know what I would do. So you ought to be able to relate to that too. If mama is gone, God has been a mother for the motherless child. I know the Lord is all right. Children, can I give you some advice? I know that your mother may be getting old or may be older, but can I just give you some advice? Let her do what she can still do. Let her do what she can still do. Don't just take everything from her. Don't stop her from doing everything. Because I can tell you now, she don't want to just sit around and rust out. Yeah, she would rather do something and wear out. So don't just take everything from her. If she can't cook, you ought to be asking her to give you the recipe. If she can't still do things that she want to do, you ought to be there to help her along the way. I have to share this with you. I told you I was making things personal today. I have witnessed with my own eyes since I've been pastor here. Mother Dupree has been in the hospital twice that I've witnessed. And both times I witnessed the love that her children have for her. And I saw it. It was genuine love. And when I got to the nursing home the other day to see Mother Dupree, one of the sisters was there, Sister Priscilla, and she and I was talking. And she told me that Brother Larry and Brother Yankee had already been there. And Yankee loved his mama, they all loved their mother. But y'all know what Yankee did. Yankee got up in the bed next to his mother and called somebody and said, guess what I'm doing? I'm up here in the bed beside my mama. That's love, y'all. That's love. Yeah. You know, when I see children loving their mother like that, that tells me that mother was a good mother to her children. And they just trying to give back. They just trying to show love. And I admire Sister Linda Gaddis, because on a regular basis, she'll go to Michigan to see about her mother. I admire Sister Ethel, because since I've been here, I got a chance to see her taking care of Brother Gaddis, her daddy, but they tell me that she took her mama in too and took care of her mama. Took care of both of them until they died. That's love for your parents. All I'm trying to say is that we only get one, y'all. And when she's gone, she's gone. Until we make it to the other side. My hat goes off to my own sister. When my mother got sick, and she really got sick more than you know, but my sister began to be the caregiver for my mother. Never been to nursing school, but she know now just as much as a lot of nurses know. She can do the things that the nurses were doing when they came in. That's showing love for your mother. But can I tell y'all who I want to give a great honor to this morning? That's my wife. For over 20 years, she has physically taking care of her mother. And I've witnessed years and years when my mother-in-law couldn't do anything for herself. duty. And you know a man wanna be first, he wanna be tended to. But my wife put all of that on hold. We couldn't take vacations. We couldn't go on date nights. We couldn't do hardly anything that normal couples do because my wife was right there taking care of her mother. Her mother called early in the morning. I had to wake my wife. I said, Mama, call you. She get up out of her bed. Late at night, I said, Mama, call you. She get up and out of her bed and take care of her mother. She did, and she's still doing whatever it takes to take care of her mother. And I thank God for the love my wife has for her mother. Since my own mom got sick, my siblings and I, we don't take a single day for granted with mother. We go see her, we call her, because we know tomorrow ain't promised. And all I'm trying to tell you is that if you have a mother that's still alive, you need to show her some love. Because I'm telling you, if when she's gone, you're going to miss her. How do I know? I've heard people tell me, but I'm going to tell you, it came so close to me until it just hurt me so bad. And when I began to think what it might be like without mama, I knew that I wasn't going to let a single day go by without cherishing her and letting her know how much I love her. I want to say this too. I really want to say this, that if there's a mother out here, if there's a mother anywhere in my reach, and you don't have a child that's honoring you, that's showing you love, call me. I'll be a son for you. I'll be a son for you, because I don't want to see no mother out there, and I'm talking about elderly mothers. I don't want to see no elderly mother out there on this day or any day that don't have nobody to say I love you and won't come and see about it. I'll be a son for you. God Almighty. As I hurry on with the message now, I'm reminded what King Solomon said in Proverbs 23 and 22. Despise not thy mother when she gets old. Now I gotta be honest with you, it burns me up when I see children act like it bothers them to help their mother when she gets old. Some folks don't wanna be bothered with their mother. When we was going to the nursing home, someone would tell us that they ain't had nobody come visit them in years. Somebody dropped them off and didn't never go back and see about it. I've seen people make their mother feel like she's a burden or inconvenience to them. After all she's done for you, she went without everything so that you could have anything. She would fight the whole world if anybody mistreated you. But now you got your good life going. You got your own family. You don't have time to worry about mama. Shame on you if you that child. Yes, yes. You need to apologize to your mama. Yes, and you need to make it right. As we unpack our lesson this morning, Proverbs 31 and 10. Solomon still gets the credit here, but actually the speaker here, the writer here was King Lemuel. And I love the way that he asked the question in verse number 10. He said, who can find a virtuous woman? He asked the question, who can find a virtuous woman? That means a righteous woman. And then I love the way he tells us how much she is worth. He said, her price now, if you can find her, he said, her price is way above rubies. Yeah, in other words, church, you can't put a monetary figure on a righteous mother. Amen. You just can't put a price on it. She's priceless. Verse 25, we see the emphasis God places on a good mother. Remember, church, God gave Solomon more wisdom than he gave any other man. And the things that Solomon, that we learned that Solomon spoke, it taught me a whole lot of things. This verse is saying a good mother or a righteous mother wears two things every day. She puts it on. She puts it on every day, a good mother. Well, what does she wear? First of all, when you look at verse 25, strength. All right. She's strong in her faith in God. And she's determined to take care of her family. A good mother puts on strength. She knows she's got to be strong for the whole household, and she got to be strong in the Lord. The second thing that she wears every day is she wears honor. Yeah, she doesn't do things to cause embarrassment to her husband or to her family. A good mother thinks about things before she does it, thinks about things before she says it. I'm talking about a virtuous woman. And the last part of that verse says, this is, and she shall rejoice in time to come. In other words, those righteous mothers that worked very hard when they were young, providing for their families, enduring all kind of pain, whether it's mentally, physically, or financially, they will reap in due time if they don't faint. God saw what you did. God knows that you sacrificed for your family, and you're going to reap the benefits from God. As I look in the congregation, many of the mothers that I see here fit that description of a virtuous woman. King Lemuel said, you shall have pleasure and rejoice when you get old, both in reflecting on the past and reaping the benefits of your life right now. And I'm certain that if you ask any good mother, if you ask any good mother, was it worth the pain? Was it worth the struggle that you went through to see your child successful and saved? Any good mother would say, yeah, it was worth it, and I'd do it all over again if I had to for my child.
That's right.
We're here to give honor to our mothers. Verse 26, King Lemuel is saying, a virtuous mother, a woman, controls her tongue. She doesn't fly off at the mouth. She doesn't have a reputation for cussing folk out. But Lemuel said, a righteous mother opens her mouth with wisdom. She gives good advice to her children. And in her tongue is the law of kindness. It's the law of kindness. Yeah, she is meek and humble. She speaks softly, sweet and gentle to everyone. This is the kind of mother some of us have and some of us have. And I thank God for our mothers. Verse number 27, a good mother looks out for the welfare of her household. She's not going to allow anything to go on in her house. She ain't going to allow just any and everything to take place in her house. If the husband won't step up and be the man, a good mother going to step up and be the man and say, that ain't going to happen in my house. King Lemuel is saying in verse number 27, a good mother don't have time to eat bread of idleness. Meaning she is dedicated to taking care of her family. It's our mothers who make sure every child has food and clothes. No matter how many children in the house. Deacon Gaddis have told me many times, I believe it's 15 children, and his mama made sure every one of them had something to eat. That's what a good mother would do. Daddy might not even be at home, but mama gonna make sure her children got food and clothes. Good mother don't sit around on the phone all day gossiping about other folk's business. And she won't talk to you and won't let you talk to her about another person's child. Why? Because a good mother know that her child might make the same mistake in life. And a good mother ain't going to entertain that kind of stuff. Verse number 28. It's one thing, y'all. It's one thing to have friends that like to be around you. But it's a whole nother feeling when your children love to be in your presence. Oh, that's a whole nother feeling now. When your children love to come see you and be around you. Yeah, in verse number 28, the king said, her children arises up and call her blessed. Yes, they realize what a blessing she is to the family and to others. Lemuel then talked about how husband will give praise to the mother for holding the family together. I got a news flash for you right quick. I got a news flash for you. When men and husbands don't want to get the wives nothing for Mother's Day, and they say, she ain't none of my mother. That's a mean thing to say. She might not be your mother, but she's the mother of your children. And she's worthy to be praised. God Almighty. Verse number 29, I love how God set the record straight. He said, many daughters. Yeah, because a lot of daughters, you know, the mother works in a lot of daughters that became nurses. You know how they got to school? Their mother was housekeepers. Their mother were cooks. The mothers went without so they could send the daughters to school. And the daughters became successful. But the Bible teaches us here that many daughters have done great things. But don't get your success twisted. Don't get it twisted. Because the word said that no matter how successful or great you may be, a good mother excels above all your greatness. I told you that nothing except the love of God can compare to a mother's love. Ain't the Lord any all right? I heard King Lemuel say in verse number 30, favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that fear the Lord, she shall be praised. We come this morning to lift up the name of Jesus, and we come to give our mothers honor. It's a blessing to have a good mother. Anybody here, thank God for your mother. You ought to cherish all the memories that you and your mother have. Anybody here know that when the world turned their back on you, it was your mother that encouraged you. She was the one that said, don't give up, but hang on in there. And God, all right, I understand why the songwriter said, a mother loves her children all the time. No matter what the crime, that mother will say, that child is mine. No matter how old you get, your mother still, she wants to comfort you. No matter how old you get, your mother still wants to hold you in her arms. And God, all right, she won't never leave you, and she won't forsake you. It's so good to have a good mother. But if your mother is gone on to glory, Jesus told me I could tell you, he will, he'll be a mother for you. All you gotta do is call on him, and he will supply your every need. Anybody ever tried him? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? But children, if your mother's still here, every chance you get, you ought to go to her. You ought to put your arms around her. You ought to say, Mama, I sure love you, and I sure thank you. You ought to call her sometime just to hear her voice, because one of these old days, and it won't be very long, you're going to look for Mama, and Mama's going to be gone. That's the reason why you ought to give her, you ought to give her flowers while she yet lives. You ought to give her flowers while she can smell them. You ought to praise your mother. She's been good to you. She the only one that will put up with your mess. She the only one that will come see about you when the whole world turned their back on you. Mother is the only one that can comfort you. Ain't God all right? If you got a good mother, you ought to praise her. You ought to not be ashamed of your mother. Some folks feel ashamed of their mother. I get mad about it when I see folks don't want to be seen with their mother. Today, you need to mend your ways. If you're not loving your mother the way God expects you to love her, today, you need to mend your ways. You need to tell her, I'm sorry. Mama ain't done all I could have done for you. But I'm gonna change now. Because I know when I was born, I know you could have put me in the dumpster like some mothers did. Yes, Lord. I know you could have went down and told them to give me an abortion. But your mother had you. She delivered you. She fed you. She took care of you. Yes, Lord. So no matter how you think, you need to honor your mother. The doors of the church is open.
Yes, Lord.
Will there be one?
Yes, Lord.
Might not know the Lord in the pardon of your sins. You ought to give your life to Jesus. I want you to hear the words of this last song. And I pray that it helps somebody. Don't be too busy for your mama. You're gonna miss out on some opportunities. Larry, I'm so proud of you for moving back to be with your mama and family. You ought to take our time for it.
They get married, some of them go to college. They move away from home to New York and Chicago and other places. But the saddest thing about it is that they forget to be
home. Can you turn it up a little bit?
So there's a thinking about a young man who left and moved away to Germany.
That's good.
And while he was there, he was critically wounded, so much so that the doctor said that he never would walk again. He had braces on his legs. And another sad thing happened to that young man. He lost his mother. And the family tried to get in touch with him, but to no avail. And finally, we see that young man standing with braces on his legs before a fresh grave, with one faded rose in his hand. As he began to drop the petals from the rose on that grave, he began to talk to his mother. These are some of the words that he was saying to his mother.
It ain't hard to please a good mother. What she really wants is to know that her children are doing all right. And you know what else a good mother loves? She loves to see her children getting along. I try to make my mother happy while she's living. I do. I do. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. The doors of the church is open. Thank God for all that he has done, all that he's doing, and all that he will do. We do have some people on our sick list. Brother William, Brandon family, the Garrett family, the Cook family, the Aretha Richmond family, DeMarcus Thomas, Mother Elmira Watkins, Betty Russell, Melvin and Bunny Hahn, Mr. and Mrs. Hughes, William McClinton, Mother Lily Lacey, Glenn Henley, Mother Mary Berry, who we talked to this morning, and she wanted to let the church know that she said hello and she misses everybody. Mother Hemphill, who we also talked to, she wanted the church to know that she loved you and she wants to come back real soon. She misses you. Devin Watson, Frankie Watson, Sister Chapman and family, Sister Vivian Kelly, the Turner family, Williams family, Kenny Moore, Felicia Smith, Tarunda Mixon Barnett, Alandis Gaddis, Mother Lucy Johnson and family, Sister Linda Gaddis and family, Don Mack, Ann Washington, Shirley Warner, Chandra German, Tucker family, Crystal Blue, Brother Rudy, Willie Hill, Mr. Wilson, and Greg Brooks. And we also want to continue to pray for Sister Anderson. She had to go to the hospital. Didn't know if she was going to make it today, but she's here. We thank God.